of Fitzgerald Fieldhouse in the campus of the University of Pittsburgh. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, the West Virginia Mountaineers are in town today, which means a lot of pageantry and a sold-out house, and yes, a lot on the line for these two teams emotionally. Larry, this is a matchup of teams that I think when you mix it all together should give us a very competitive game today. Pitt, yes, they're 1-2 or 1-3, but they've faced two of the five best teams in the country already.
Yeah, and it's really a club. I think when Ralph Bullard accepted this position, he felt like he was going to be able to take a club that had something to compete against in the Big East, and they have struggled, but it's been principally because of injuries, particularly to Jerry McCullough, that's really hurt them. And this is a club that is not very deep. They basically play seven guys.
And for West Virginia, yes, they're 2-1, but they're two wins over undistinguished competition in Alaska Fairbanks and Robert Morris. But hey, they were beaten on the road at Towson State in their last game.
Yeah, and we talk about clubs that really don't have a lot of players. West Virginia is somewhat the same boat as Pitt. They've got the Sheldon Jefferson, who is really playing for his first year. Solheim and Owens are both freshmen. Then you've got Cyrus Jones, who is the junior college player. So a lot of first-year players on this West Virginia club.
And that's something that Gale Catlin really hasn't had to deal with too much, has he?
No, he hasn't. And it's kind of interesting because he lost six players last year, his first six scorers. And really, guys, I think that were somewhat underachievers. And these guys now have to step up and become players automatically. You know, they're only a year away from going into the Big East, so they better get ready to play.
Well, that's what makes this, I think, a little bit more intriguing than it usually is, and it's always a border war. But these two teams starting next year will play each other twice, home and home every year, instead of just the one. Tom Bees and Larry Connolly live at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse in Pittsburgh. Our Reebok starting lineups as West Virginia meets Pitt. Look out for number 20 Zane Shaw. Had a big game against the Panthers last year. For the Mountaineers, for head coach Ralph Willard in his first year here at Pitt, the key guy there, Larry, Andre Allridge at point guard.
Yeah, the replacement for Jerry McCullough, who went down with that knee injury in September. He's the guy that's got to carry them, and very frankly has not done it too well up to this point.
All right, Pittsburgh, undermanned, admittedly so, taking on a West Virginia team in transition. Live college hoop action, Atlantic 10 versus the Big East on ESPN, and away we go. And the West Virginia Mountaineers control it in the person of Brent Solheim. And right to the basket they go, and it's blocked. Cyrus Jones had it blocked, and a jump ball, or their held ball right off the bat.
Well, Cyrus Jones with a good strong move inside, but Varga right there. Take a look again. What's Jones now? Good baseline move. Got by Antigua. Look on the other side. Oh, that was a terrific block.
All right, the block there by Jamie Peterson of Pittsburgh and the Pitt Panthers. Well, Jaime Peterson of Pittsburgh with a block and the Pitt Panthers immediately into their offense. Orlando Antigua to Varga for the slam dunk.
Varga immediately up and in. Transfer from Vincennes in Detroit. This guy's a good player.
6'6 sophomore Varga, got a lot of beep to him. 2-0 Pittsburgh. Sheldon Jefferson launches for long range and Varga the rebound.
Pitt really struggled this week, particularly against St. John's, but they look like a different club here today, don't they?
Jaime Peterson going for the three-point play.
Tom, it's amazing when you get a rivalry. You know, West Virginia and Pitt really do not like each other very much. And Pitt's come out here with fire in their eyes today. Watch the movement of the basketball coming right into your living room. Good pass on the other end. Good catch. Peterson up and strong with the basket.
As Jaime Peterson gets ready for the foul shot, his Panthers leading it early, 4-0. There you see his stats, just about double figures in both categories.
He had a pretty good game against St. John this week. 18 points, 12 rebounds, and a cut eye.
All right, 5-0. Pitt out to the early lead. Sheldon Jefferson starts the break, and finishing it off is Zane Shaw, who draws the foul.
Zane Shaw, the only player that Gale Catlin has back from last year, and he was his seventh leading scorer. All the rest of the faces out there are new this year.
Shaw goes to the line for two. They say he makes things happen. He's out of Allegheny Community College in Cumberland, Maryland.
He's the leading returning scorer for this West Virginia Mountaineer club. It's an interesting conversation you and I had with Gale Catlin before the game today. He says, boy, I really needed those extra 2 weeks they gave us back, particularly with all those new faces.
Well, any coach will tell you that he's basically a basketball teacher, and Gale had to do more of that this preseason than in his career, he said.
I think the thing, his fashion statement got to be in his locker room. I saw those Snoopy socks that his daughter gave him.
We'll get a shot of those as time allows. Wearing his Christmas haberdashery about 2 weeks early. Shaw gets the Mountaineers on the board. They trail at 5-2.
West Virginia immediately into full court pressure. 1-2-2 zone. They'll match up out of this. Try to trap.
And Aldridge. Etheridge, number 12. He's the man to watch, the point guard. Has to make good decisions for Pitt. And Antigua has it stripped away. And laying it up and in for West Virginia's Jefferson.
Jefferson with a good strip that time, took it all the way. Agaloo with a good idea to just back off. He was not going to be able to do anything to defend that.
And a turnover. That has really been the bugaboo of Pitt in the early season.
And it just happens to be Orlando Antigua who commits the second turnover in a row. Two possessions for him and two turnovers.
In their last game against UMass, there you see it graphically. 17 turnovers in the first half, 27 for the game. When you're playing one of the top teams in America on the road, you can't do that.
And what happens? You get beat badly, as they did.
That's right. Mountaineers trying to take the lead, but the jumper drawing a foul is Cyrus Jones. Came off the pick, put it up, and got slapped on the forearm.
Well, there's a man, Ralph Willard, the head coach at Pitt. In his first year here, coming from Western Kentucky, great background as an assistant with Rick Pitino at Kentucky and also with the Knicks and at Providence. Guy's had a lot of coaching experience. And you know what? Things are only going to get better for this Pitt program because I think he's one of the class gentlemen and one of the better coaches in this country.
Well, he's already had a great signing period in the preseason signing period. And he told me yesterday, Tom, you will not recognize this Pitt team next year. I will have at least 8 or 9 new faces on this squad.
Well, I think he realizes, as we all do in college basketball, that the Big East is back. They've got solid teams this year. They dominated the 80s. They've been their way for about 3 or 4 years, but I think that Big East Conference is well on its way back to being one of the dominant conferences in the country.
1 for 2 for Cyrus Jones, and a loose ball rebound controlled by Ulrich. Andre Ulrich, he's a junior, taking over for the injured Jerry McCullough, and those are big shoes to fill here at Pitt.
That was a big blow, I think, to this Pitt club, and really Ralph Willard not just got blindsided by that, because he really needed McCullough to run the show on this club. A lot of pressure on Ulrich to take over.
Ulrich with 3-point land. Fargo with a strong rebound, but couldn't control it. And carries it out of bounds. It'll be West Virginia basketball. Well, Jerry McCullough injured his knee in a pickup game in this very building a few months ago.
Well, now that's what you give up. 13 points, 7 assists, 4 rebounds, almost 3 steals per game. That's a lot to lose, particularly when you expect to have him back and really be a major contributor and a leader to this club.
Well, he was going to be the senior point guard running the show. The good news is, I suppose, he will be back next year.
And with what looks like a pretty good recruiting class that Ralph Willard's bringing in.
So Tyrese Agaloo kicks out of bounds, and there's a look at McCullough, who would love to be out there today. Selden Jefferson with it for West Virginia.
Hits it back in the zone defense. A little bit of a matchup, trap on the wings. Marvin Antigua with an intelligent trap. You got to pick your spots on the floor if you're going to trap.
Right corner. Hits the iron from Zane Shaw. Pitt knocks it out. West Virginia ball still tied at 5.
Tom, you know Ralph Willard really likes to go up and down the floor. He likes a 94-foot game, somewhat helter-skelter, good athletic play. Difficult to do that right now with the players he's got in this particular lineup.
Well, he's got a short bench. He says he just wants to go to the locker room at halftime close and then go with 5 or 6 guys in the second half full tilt and see what that brings him. Zane Shaw gives West Virginia its first lead of the game at 7-5.
Watch Jefferson out on top. He's trying to keep Aldridge from penetrating. Not a great deal of pressure. There comes the trap.
Get it to Varga in the corner. Trying to hit Peterson on the baseline. Stolen away by Shaw. 3-on-2. Nice passing underneath. And it results in a layup for Damian Owens.
Good-looking freshman. Gale counts very high on this young man. He had 24 points and 8 rebounds in the opening win over Robert Morris.
They double-team Ulrich, but he gets it to Antigua. Mountaineers by 4, 9-5. Varg is 3-pointer, no, and Orlando Antigua the rebound.
Pitt having difficulty with their outside shooting.
And that's really difficult for them, Larry, because by their own admission, they rely on the 3-point shot.
Good pump fake.
Agaloo from 2. Agaloo knocks it down. He's from Athens, Greece. Right back, West Virginia, in and out for Jones.
Ball has just missed an easy chipper.
Zane Shaw controls it. Baseline no good for Owens. And Mountaineers keep it. Officials today are Tim Higgins, Jody Sylvester, and Rich Sanfilippo. First time out of the game, 4 minutes into action. 9-7, West Virginia. The holiday.
high spirit abounding here at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse in the campus of Pitt. I didn't know the gold-colored beards and hair were in. You learn something everywhere you go, Larry.
Only here.
152nd meeting today. The backyard brawl or the border war between West Virginia and Pitt. West Virginia all time has a big lead, but every one of these games takes on its own story.
Kind of like the old Hatfields and McCoys, huh? Right in the mountains?
That's right. Double teamed and driving by was Owens, but he couldn't make it go, and Antigua's foul on the rebound.
You know, Damian Owens has really had tough luck. He had an easy stick back a few minutes ago, missed one, missed the baseline jumper, and just had a follow right here. Couldn't get this one to go. Got right by Varga. Nice move to the baseline. Had an easy shot, laid it up, too hard off the glass. 0 for 3 in his last three attempts, and really pretty easy shots.
Teammates call Owens the worm for his rebounding ability. Had 8 boards in an early season victory against Robert Morris.
West Virginia with token pressure.
Antigua, nice turnaround in the lane. That's Orlando. Now his brother Oliver is on the squad, but we don't expect him to see action today.
Well, he does double duty. He also handles the towels besides shooting the ball and passing it.
I.e., he's a manager. Well, yeah, that really shows the manpower problem that Willard had here at Pitt. There's his brother.
We weren't kidding about that, folks. He really is. He's the walk-on player manager, and he's Orlando's brother.
They also have the punter from the Pitt football team, Nate Cochran. He's somewhere on that bench. We'll get a shot of him as time permits.
Right where he averages almost 42 yards a punt this
That's
year.
Right.
Oh, pretty good.
Game tied at 9. Antigua open for the moment. Down low it goes. Thomas is blocked. And it's controlled by Cyrus Jones.
Leon Agnew with a nice block inside.
Hesitation drive by Jones, in and out. Varga on the baseline, guarded by Solheim. Turnaround, up and in.
Well, Varga, nice looking athlete, isn't he?
Yeah.
Played a couple other sports besides basketball.
At 20 points and 12 rebounds did Chad Varga against Massachusetts. He's out of Detroit, Michigan. Jefferson down low to Solheim, was double teamed. Right wing shot by Zane Shaw, not close. Solheim the board.
Solheim getting it done inside. Good effort to get that rebound.
Shaw with a spin move, doesn't make it, but draws a foul.
Yeah, Tom, you got to give a credit right there to Brent Solheim for keeping that ball alive. Anytime you can get a guy to go inside, get an offensive rebound, and get it back to a player with another chance for another shot. At this point, 2 free throws, you're getting the job done. Here's the shot from the outside by Zane Shaw. Watch it kick to the outside. Solheim with a good movement to the outside to pick it up. He gathers it, feeds it back. Here's the drive again inside by Shaw, the spin move and the foul. And he gives the Mountaineers an opportunity to pick up 2 extra points with his hustle.
Well, I know Antigua will take a rest for Pittsburgh, and Jason Mayle, sophomore out of Forest City, Pennsylvania, comes in. Mayle had a good game against Massachusetts also, 17 points, most of them from long range. Free throw shooting has always been a concern for West Virginia. And there's the punter we were talking about, Nate Cochran of Pitt, filling out the roster.
He's got pretty good size, too, at 6'5", 210.
He averages about 5 minutes a game so far, and 41.8 yards a punt.
We saw Johnny Majors walk in here just a few minutes ago, back up there to sit down. Come in to watch his punter, maybe?
Maybe.
Don't hurt him.
I hope he can stay to the end. Allridge on the right side. Pittsburgh up by 2. And with 15 seconds on the shot clock, Solheim of West Virginia whistled for a foul.
I'll tell you what, Vargas and Solheim are really going at it. Watch on the inside right here. You can see Varga right here. Now watch him wrap. Now the turn, Solheim trying to get around to the inside. You know what? It's always the second guy that gets caught.
Yep, absolutely.
It's not the first guy. Varga had the hook, they didn't see it. Solheim held, he did get caught.
And welcome to wrestling practice.
Pretty good wrestling team here at Pitt, huh?
Yeah, they do. Good tradition. Looked like a couple of chicken wings trying to be executed there. Thomas in the mail. Varga. Madly overshot that one. Pitt controls the board. They'll leave Aldridge open all day from out there.
Yeah, they really back off.
Mail, he likes this. Margaret with a tough board draws the foul. He's an impressive specimen, that Margaret.
Well, the transfer from Vincent's getting it done so far for this Pitt club. Watch again. Top part of your screen. Watch Chad Varga go to war on this backboard. Good strong rebound. He goes right back up on the inside. The good turn and the foul down inside and the second one there for Damian Owens.
And the 15th foul on West Virginia. And Varga goes to the line with a chance to increase the lead to four.
He looks like a football player.
Yeah, I wouldn't want him to run into me.
6'6", 235.
Levon Lamb comes in for West Virginia. Damian Owens will have a seat. Yale Catlett, the first three games he was telling us, he rotated, eight, nine, sometimes 10 players trying to get a feel for this club.
Well, it's also a basketball team that when you take this many new faces, Tom, it's very difficult. You got to get to know the new faces, just like the new faces got to get to know the coach and the system. I'll tell you what he said, we needed that extra 2 weeks. He was serious because he has a number of junior college players, freshmen and second year players, one in particular, Selvin Jefferson, who had to sit out last year. So they needed that extra time.
Varga makes the Panther lead at four.
Varga now with 6 points.
Torrey Wilson finally executes the inbounds, and this is Jefferson.
Oh, good ball handling between the legs.
Save on the sideline to Jefferson. And a pass down low, and fouled there is Torrey Wilson.
One of the things Gail Catlett talked about Selvin Jefferson when we were downstairs discussing his players was the fact that he's playing the point guard, but he wasn't sure exactly whether that was the right position for him.
Saw that game between Maryland and Massachusetts. I saw Maryland on Thursday night, albeit against Colgate, but very impressive team for Gary Williams again, and we all know about UMass.
How about Joe Smith? You like him?
Oh, I love that kid. He's something else.
That Maryland club is really good. In a league that I think is the best in the country.
Absolutely, top to bottom. They feel they can challenge North Carolina for the regular season title.
Well, I agree with that.
Here's Selden Jefferson out there midcourt.
I wouldn't count the Dukies out either.
No, you can never do that. Good George Washington club went down there the other day, got blown away. Wilson shot, rebounded by Aldridge, and the referee is pointing Pittsburgh's way.
It actually went off of Torrey Wilson. Thought perhaps they were going to give it back to West Virginia because I kind of felt like Aldridge had it off of him. But watch again, you can see right here. He lost the basketball going up. Well, Wilson had an easy one, too.
You know what? That did go off Aldridge. The referee had his back turned, but those things happen. Steal by Jefferson, and going back to recover for Pitt is Mayo. Down low, and a block. Maybe you heard one of the West Virginia folks say, get that out of here. And a foul as Jefferson was steaming up the court.
Yeah, I hear that every night at Sports Center.
Along with splash and good and a lot of
yeah, all the other adjectives and cliches. Good move inside, good block. Antigua tried to make a very difficult pass right there. He gets the ball stripped and heads the other way. It really felt like Orlando Antigua had an open shot from about 6 feet right in front of the basket. You got to take that.
Yeah.
Don't overpass the ball.
Try to make the perfect play instead of just taking the shot.
Could be Tom Orlando's not having a very good shooting year. He's somewhat reluctant to put that ball up. He's only shooting 34% coming into this game.
12:29 to go in the half. Pittsburgh up by four.
Hit right back into that matchup zone defense. Good trap.
Making the shot and shooting at the air ball of Vaughn Land, but the rebound is up and in. Leon Agnew put it down.
Again, the token pressure by the Mountaineers. Pitts had no problem with this at all.
And that's something that the head coach was concerned about. Ralph Willard said his team has really not handled pressure very well this season. He was working on it all day yesterday in practice.
I always feel like when coaches come in for their first year, whatever school they go to, there's always the tendency to remember the first team that you had when you move into a new situation. And I know this is probably going to be true with Ralph Willard. There may be other clubs 15, 20 years down the road, but you always remember your first one.
Absolutely. One thing he pointed out, he says, my kids never quit. They always give me the effort, and you got to start with that. And that's never been wanting this season. The Gaylou shot, no good. Here comes West Virginia looking to tie or go ahead. And off the hands of LaJuan Lamb. Bad pass. Timeout with 11:46 to go in the first half. A helter-skelter first half of basketball. It's West Virginia by one with the basketball.
Pitt back into that zone. 2-3. West Virginia attacking right now. One looks like a 1-3-1. Good screen down inside. Now Pitt's matching up.
Aldridge on Jefferson. Jefferson rubs him off. Gets it down. All the traveling is called on Leon Agnew.
Good defensive work that time down inside by Pitt. Wouldn't allow the basketball to come through there. Anytime you can keep that ball out of the middle on a zone defense, you're in pretty good shape. Neither of these clubs known for their outside shooting.
And Tink with a double team, it gets it to Aldridge. And Mayo, as he's trying to make a pass, is shoved from behind, and Leon Agnew can't believe it.
See, if you're in the NBA, Mayo would realize that you got to put it up there and get those two shots. On the pass off, you don't get it.
On Pittsburgh, that should be the sixth team foul. I'm sorry, on West Virginia, that is the ninth foul, so Mayo will go to the foul line.
In this situation, he'll get the one and one. In fact, on the next foul, they'll be shooting two. But had he attempted the shot, he would have been guaranteed two shots.
And you're seeing from the Mountaineers coming back in is Brent Solheim. And again, Pitt having foul shooting difficulty. Selwyn Jefferson. And Mayo reaches in and draws what he considers to be a ticky-tack foul, but it counts. Ralph Willard is beautiful. He's not saying a word, but his facial expression says everything.
Watch again down inside. The good move comes right here. Now you go down the right. Here's the I might get a little bit of a push or a push off of the arm. I think I let that one go.
Still, Pitt is not in the one-on-one situation as yet. So the Mountaineers inbound.
West Virginia looking over this Pitt defense right here.
Open on the baseline is Owens, but now he's closed off, and here come the Panthers. Aldridge, and he just lost the handle. Back the other way is Shaw. And we got basketballs going every which way today.
But none of them going in the basket.
This has been a very workmanlike performance by both teams. Not a lot of flow.
You know what it is, Tom? It's mistakes of enthusiasm. Both these clubs want to play well. They want to go out and play hard, and they are. Just not able to control the basketball. Turnovers have really been a bugaboo for both these clubs. You got to take care of it.
A little decorum, I think, is called for here. And Tingla, nice pass down, and it goes for Hyman Peterson, and he'll get one.
Once again, they break that press, and they get inside of West Virginia's defense. Anytime you can get past that initial flow, now watch, here comes a double team. Good recognition to the wing, to the middle, down inside. Antigua with a nice bounce pass. In fact, we could hear the slap on the arm all the way from over here.
Well, for Solheim of West Virginia, that's his third personal foul, so he'll sit out again. And Agnew takes his place.
The most decorative Band-Aid right there.
Yes, looks like he graduated from top-ranked boxing right under Big East Hoops here on ESPN.
C marks the spot.
Peterson completes the three-point play, and Pittsburgh is again up by two. 4 points, the largest lead for either side today. And Jefferson loses control, and Pittsburgh whistled for a foul.
Got a hold at midcourt. Timmy Higgins right on top of it.
And Sheldon Jefferson will go to the line to shoot one and one, that being the 17th foul on Pitt. Here's Orlando Antigua. Coach Willard was saying, in a way, he felt sorry for Antigua because he's playing on some fine teams here at Pitt. And this team this year is going to struggle a little bit. Yes, this is Antigua's last year.
Well, the other thing about Antigua that I find is, I mean, I think this guy, as we all know, he was given the most courageous award by the United States Basketball Writers Association in Charlotte last year. This young man has gone through a lot of adversity. I mean, a lot of people remember the bullet in the brain that was removed. But he is a very, very courageous youngster and a terrific young man.
Very bubbly personality, very friendly young man, you're right. Game tied at 17. As the Mountaineers convert the free throws. And still Pittsburgh ball.
Seldon Jefferson, all he had to do was just let it go, and it would have been their ball. He couldn't handle it. Goes off his fingertips, and Pitt gets it back.
Antigua will inbound.
One of those days, Tom.
Oh, I got my sneakers in the trunk. Knocked out of bounds by Seldon.
We got an old Columbia player in the trunk out there that might want to take you one-on-one.
Bill Murray's got nothing on me, friend, let me tell you. Aguilu, down low to Varga. Nice move by Varga, but he blows the layup.
Oh, that was palming. He turned it over.
Zane Shaw may have gotten away with one there. 8:20 to go in the first half. Tied at 17.
Bad pass. Oh, that was bad. Jefferson made another bad pass.
Pittsburgh with the numbers, 3-on-2, and Ulrich is fouled on the way.
Looks like Cyrus Jones got him as he made the turn.
Foul shooting situation for Pittsburgh as the Penn Quakers having an easy time today.
Knee high on Hovind.
And Chris Berman is happy. Brown has won again. Beating Maine. So Ulrich will be at the line shooting two shots as West Virginia has gone beyond the 10 foul limit.
You know, when you've got a player like Ulrich who steps in here and realizes he's been the backup guard to Jerry McCullough, and then all of a sudden being thrust into the position of being the point guard and really leading the club, really changes your whole persona, because all of a sudden, instead of having that role as backup, you assume the responsibility of running a team. You really have to step up and become a player. And that's difficult, particularly when you've been there in a couple of years as the backup.
Mentally and physically, Larry. I mean, here's Ulrich averaging 31 minutes a game so far. I don't think he planned on that before the season. Low layup there by Shaw. Pitt with the rebound. Pittsburgh with the ball and a one-point lead. Ulrich's pass out of bounds. It'll go over to West Virginia, so yet another turnover. 7:53 left to go in a turnover playing first half, but it's close. Pitt by Pitt fans are rooting for West Virginia to keep a hold of that case of turnover-itis, because they did it again.
West Virginia straight man-to-man defense. No gimmick this time. No matchups. Going to come out and play them straight.
And a whistle as Antigua received the pass, a foul on Pitt.
Yeah, Chad Varga with an illegal screen.
Takeaway by Varga on Zane Shaw and take it right back.
Playing giveaway.
Nobody wants that rock. Lecorey dies for it. Finally, Shaw says enough of this and he goes to the basket.
Come on, guys, it's Christmas time. Quit giving the gifts away. It's too early.
A ragged up and down style of basketball today. And that's the third foul on Orlando Antigua. Some loose action going on the court.
Well, there's the problem really for both clubs. You see Pitt with 11, West Virginia with 9 already, and we've still got 7:04 left to go in the first half.
Zane Shaw missing the first of two. Pittsburgh leading it by a point. Shaw's in a bit of a slump in this game, missing his last four at the line.
This has not been a Picasso at all.
No, no. This is one of those you throw against the wall and see how it sticks.
Free throws, West Virginia and Pitt. You can see how they're shooting.
Shaw, 1 out of 2, ties in at 18. Aguilu, double teamed in the corner, does a good job. Ulrich, the pull-up jump. And control there by Agnew of West Virginia.
They're going to pull it out. Take a look at Pitt's defense. This West Virginia club, while they don't handle the ball very well, they really are showing a little bit more patience right now. And I think Gail Catlis decided, hey, let's back this thing off. We've got too many turnovers. We'll take a look and see if we just can't get a little more patience down here.
Mountaineers, of course, ending their association with the Atlantic 10 after this year. The jump shot good by Shaw.
Maybe a good idea to show a little bit of patience. There's the trap of the Mountaineers.
Pitt's handling that pretty well for the most part. West Virginia is daring Pittsburgh to shoot from the outside.
Yeah, it's great to make five or six passes around the perimeter, but eventually somebody's got to take the shot.
Shot clock inside of 10. Agalu, he's short. Varga powers it to the hole. He missed the layup. Mail on the rebound. Agalu again.
Nice hustle by Pitt that time. Everybody in the act. Offensive rebounding, the good kick-out pass to the corner, and Agalu nails one.
Youngster out of Athens, Greece, puts Pitt up by one. Right back for West Virginia's Ligori. The shot no good, and it'll be Pitt ball. And the Panthers will go to the foul line.
Yeah, watch the good bounce pass. Bailey got it out to the corner. Agalu right on top of it. A nice spin. He missed one just a couple of seconds earlier from that same spot. That one went through.
Varga is the young man going to the line now. Of course, West Virginia long since over the foul limit. Varga will shoot two. Another one. Every dead ball, it seems Gail Catlett shuttling in bodies, in and out, in and out.
Ralph Willard doing the same with his Pitt club. Yeah, they got three new coaches in the Big East this year. Willard here, obviously, George Blaney from Holy Cross went to Seton Hall, and then Pete Gillen goes to Providence from Xavier. A few changes in the Big East.
A few changes everywhere, it seems like. Varga, one out of two. The cosmic makeup of conferences around the country continuing to change.
Varga now with 8 points.
Which is a big deal in a 22-20 game. Cyrus Schultz pressured by Ulrich. Off the hands of Shaw, couldn't hold on. Another turnover, West Virginia.
Not a bad pass, Tom. I thought it was there. Just mishandled. Anytime you can penetrate a defense like that and get an open pass to a guy, he should be able to catch it. He tried one hand instead of two hands.
Varga muscles it up. Ivan Peterson, and he is blocked from behind, but a foul on LeVon Lamb, who thinks he got all ball.
I want to tell you what, I thought he had a lot of ball, too. Watch down inside. LeVon Lamb right here. Number 42. Does he get all ball? Varga going strong. There's the body. Watch him come back on this other side. Ah, he got his arm. Good call. But didn't they always? They're always right.
Just ask the referees, they'll tell you.
There's no adjudication on this court. You take what you get.
Peterson misses the first of two. Ligori is back in, and Zane Shaw sits. And after every substitution, Gail Catlett goes over to the youngster who sits down and has a few words for him. Continually teaching the game's going on.
Well, with this club, he's got to, with all these new faces. Seven newcomers. Actually, three guys who averaged less than 7 minutes a game last year.
Under five to go in the first half. Pittsburgh by three over West Virginia. Tonight it's Memphis at Georgetown from Toronto at 8:30 Eastern. Double team in the corner. Ligori just got it pass away. Zeldin Jefferson says enough of this. Buries the three.
Well, they were lucky that time. Got a good outlet pass to there. And the thing about Jefferson, if he's open like that, he's got time to set. He's going to nail it.
That ties it up at 23.
Anytime you come off the Brits of Brooklyn, you know you can shoot the ball.
Oh, yeah. Huh? That's a prerequisite.
Playing with those chain nets.
I love those things. They never broke.
Hard to cut down, though.
Yeah, well, that's true. We found ways, though, in Philly. We found ways. Loose ball again. Here come the Mountaineers. Sheldon Jefferson, basket, and it counts.
And Jefferson now with five straight. The tray and an opportunity for six straight if he can make this free throw.
You've talked to me about him before the game today. What an excellent player he was.
Yeah, he is. Now watch this move. It's a young man who had to sit out with academic difficulties last year, and that's always hard coming out of high school to refocus yourself and get ready to play in college. It's like he's done that, averaging 17 a game coming into this particular contest. Having a good afternoon.
They'll sit down. Back in, 4 minutes to go in the half. West Virginia by two, looking to make it three. And a timeout called with 4 minutes even left to go in the first half. It's been close from the start until now. West Virginia by three. With Larry Conley, Tom Meese live from Pittsburgh. But Ralph Willard's team is 1-3. That's true. But he's had to play North Carolina and UMass so far this season on the road. It's tough, isn't it, Ralph?
Well, you know, obviously we have a lot of young people who haven't played a great deal of minutes, and it was a tough challenge going out and playing at North Carolina and then at UMass within a week of one another. But, you know, it's a learning experience, hopefully something we're going to get better from. We did some good things in both of those games. We just consistently didn't do enough good things.
Anytime you have an opportunity to play two clubs like that, you do find out things about your club. Sometimes you don't want to get buried, though. It can really hurt your confidence to get killed. And I think Ralph Willard's a good enough coach with his experience to keep his club from getting pointed in that direction.
Well, he's going to have to go this year with a shortened bench because of the aforementioned injury to McCullough. And Mr. Gant also is hurt here, one of their power forwards. He'll be back soon. He'll help. West Virginia steals the ball again, and Pitt steals it right back.
T.O. to T.O.
We may have a record performance here for total turnovers in a game.
We have more turnovers than we have field goals.
True. But it's close. It has been from the start. 22 turnovers and counting between the two sides now. 24. Aldridge guarded closely by David Liguori. Shot clock down to six. Aguilu. Varga on the tip. Thomas, and Pitt really hit the board.
Yeah, Thomas, there's one thing you say positive about Pitt today. They really do a good job on the offensive glass. They really have gone in there and battled hard. Peterson and Varga in particular.
Jones and Jefferson pull it back out. And a whistle as Sheldon Jefferson was on his way to the hoop. Fouls on Andre Aldridge.
Tell you another thing these two clubs are going to get involved in here is some foul problems. If you keep going this way in the second half, we can see a whole lot of new faces.
That's a second personal on Aldridge. And Sheldon Jefferson will be at the line for two. Jefferson broke the marks of Mark Jackson in high school.
Bishop Laughlin's turned out a number of quality players. Andre Riddick's one, too,
yeah.
Went down to Kentucky.
As Ralph Willard has a connection with Kentucky. He was an assistant under Rick Pitino, both with the Knicks and at Kentucky.
He also has a son who's transferred up here, too, who will play next year. We may get into this discussion about that in the second half. I want to talk a little bit about that.
Interesting story.
Yeah.
2:40 to go here in the first half. West Virginia leads by two.
WVU right back in our man-to-man defense.
Thomas with his own miss.
Well, the offensive rebound continues to be on the plus side for the Pitt crew.
Very strong off of that glass. They continue to do that all afternoon. They're going to make this thing close as it is right now, tied at 27.
Pittsburgh on the day, Larry. 13 turnovers, 12 fouls, and 9 baskets. A rugged sort of game, but a three-point shot looks beautiful for Cyrus Jones. Mountaineers lead it by three. Aguilu tries to tie it. And fouled over the top on the rebound was Zane Shaw. And I believe Varga is the young man who got him.
Yeah, Varga just picked up his third foul, and because of it, the good inside position by Shaw kept him away from the basket. Then maybe Gil Catlett passed a message on to his club. Hey, guys are killing us off of that glass. Let's start blocking out a little bit. Shaw did that time, kept Varga away and drew the foul.
And Vargas sits, and Jason Mayle comes in to replace him. And again, a lot of foul shooting here because of the total team foul situation. Arkansas winning big. UMass retaining that three-point lead. It's going to go down to the wire.
Michigan State up on Nebraska by three. Boy, they got a couple of great guards. Sean Resford and Eric Snow. Outstanding pair of guards.
Big Ten, ACC. Are those the two top conferences this year?
I think I may lean toward the ACC and the SEC.
SEC.
SEC is very, very good this year. Strong Arkansas club, obviously. Kentucky right there. Florida's good. And the surprise teams in that league may be LSU, Alabama, and Mississippi State. To this point, playing very well, all three of them.
Pitt's got a trip into SEC country next Saturday. Their next game will be at Georgia. In and out on the second of two. It's 31-27, West Virginia by four. And that's been the biggest lead for either team today. Correction, it was 5-0 West Virginia at the start. That's the biggest lead. Thomas finally gets it to Peterson, who missed the layup. And is blocked in the rebound. And draws the foul on the second board.
How tough is it in there today? Thomas just survived getting the ball inside. He got it to Peterson. Look at this. He lost it, came back with it. He's still struggling to get a hold of it. Wide open is Peterson, and he misses. What happens? He goes back, gets it again, misses again, goes back for a third time and gets fouled.
And the point again, well taken, you made about Pitt hustling on the offensive glass.
Yeah, it's been the one shining moment, I think, in the first half here has been the backboard work on the offensive end.
Well, our Del DeFosse and halftime report with Carl Ravitch coming up. Highlights of that big one between UMass and Maryland and other scores and highlights from around the top 25 in college hoops. That's coming up on your Del DeFosse and halftime report. Jaime Peterson draws Pitt within two at 31-29. Well, this is what Ralph Willard of Pitt wanted to accomplish there. He wanted to be close at halftime and then come out and really press him in the second half.
Well, you talked about the beginning of the game. He says, I really want to keep this cup close. If I can, I will throw everything at him in the second half.
Down low. Nice entry pass and layup for Zane Shaw.
Zane Shaw really having a pretty good first half here for West Virginia.
Other scores around the country. Arkansas winning big. Still tight down in Baltimore.
It's a great game between two great clubs.
Great pointer, as good as gold by Jason Mayall.
Mayall's got a nice stroke.
He does.
He gets himself set up really well, and he's got that good extension, the good follow through. Not the splash, but certainly into the net.
Under a minute to go in the first half. West Virginia by one, by three, is Jefferson with the off-balance jumper. He's a creator.
Two stars we've got in for West Virginia in the first half have been Zane Shaw and Seldon Jefferson.
They've been pretty much the show. Shot clock is turned off, under 20 seconds left in the half.
That's a walk, that's
yeah.
A walk.
Yep. All right, so Terry Segalu picked up that pivot foot and he knew it. 11 seconds to go. West Virginia will inbound.
Seldon Jefferson telling somebody to take the ball out of bounds. Who gets the responsibility for it? David Liguori.
Liguori into Jefferson. West Virginia hoping to go in with a 5 or 6 point lead.
Good idea. Good trap. They're going to take a timeout with 3 seconds.
Yale Catlett, yeah. Called for the timeout with 3 seconds to go in the half. Interesting. West Virginia leads Pitt by three.
Mountaineers leading by three with 3 seconds left in the first half here. We want you to watch Seldon Jefferson with the ball right here on the sideline. All he has to do is just bounce it off a Pitt player out of bounds, and they've got it. What does he do? He calls a timeout, and boy, is that ever a wasted timeout. I'm sure Gail Catlett let him know that when they went to the huddle.
Well, Zane Shaw will inbound. 3 seconds for West Virginia to do something here. Three-pointer is Shaw, and that'll do it for the first time. After the first 20 minutes of play, the West Virginia Mountaineers leave the court here at Fitzgerald Fieldhouse with a 3-point lead over the Pitt Panthers.